Who doesn't like to have cakes? But what if I tell you that cutting the cake also involves some mathematical skills? There are good ways of cutting a cake and there are not so good ways of cutting the cake. The traditional way or the classical way of cutting the cake is by doing a wedge or making out a sector. So when you cut the cake, usually you put your knife in the center and you take out a wedge from it like this. Taking out the wedge or a sector like this, this part then gets exposed to the air and loses its moisture. Can you think of another way of cutting the cake? A way in which there is minimum exposure of the surface so that the cake doesn't get dry? Can you think of a mathematical way to cut the cake? While you think of so, I'll go and bake another one for you. And here's the second cake to demonstrate the second method.
A British mathematician, Galton, said in the famous magazine Nature that to his amusement and satisfaction, the ordinary method of cutting out a wedge is very faulty. He proposed another way to cut the pieces so that the remaining pieces can be co-joined to give least exposure. And this was his method. So here's my cake and I'm going to slice it from one chord. Parallel to it, I slice it again. You take out the slice and eat the cake. The remaining part can be joined so that there is least exposure. Now when you join this, you can keep it together or put a rubber band around it so that it doesn't get exposed. Next time when you have to cut the cake again, put another slice here, the next one parallel to this. My cake is a bit crusty, so it's crumbling. And you have this pieces. Co-join the remaining part, you would see that there is least exposure to the surface and it remains perfectly moisture. Well, whatever the procedure may be, cutting the cake has to be a cakewalk and I'm going to enjoy it.